Today, let's together celebrate the birth of the Lord, the Divine, the Almighty. Good morning, everyone. I extend a very warm welcome to Principal Sir, my dear teachers and fellow mates on this joyous occasion of Christmas. We all know that Christmas is different this year, but this cannot dampen its spirit. We might not be together hand in hand, but we are together heart to heart. After all, Christmas isn't a season. It's a feeling. A feeling of the presence of our near and dear ones, virtual or otherwise, which will be all the more precious than usual this year.
Christmas is much more than just festive decor and exchanging gifts. So, on this beautiful day, our friends of class 5 will tell us the glorious story and the true meaning of this festival.
Christmas is a time for merriment and cheer. It's also a time to thank God we are here. So, when we wake on a bright Christmas morn, it's the day our Savior was born. Christmas is the most important festival for Christians. It brings home a spirit of cheer across the entire world. Christmas dates back to the time when Jesus was born to Mother Mary in a small stable. This festival is celebrated to mark the arrival of Jesus into this world. It is celebrated on December 25th every year. It falls on the winter solstice day in the Roman calendar and is the darkest night of the year.
Jesus Christ is the very personification of divinity. He was born at a time when ignorance, superstition, greed, hatred, and hypocrisy prevailed upon the land. Purity was forgotten and morality was neglected. The birth of Jesus came as a ray of hope and marked the beginning of the journey towards enlightenment.
Christmas is the season of joy, peace and happiness. It is the time when families get together and cook delicious food for each other, bake cakes and share them with their loved ones. The core values of sharing are instilled in children from the beginning. A few days before the festival, people decorate the Christmas tree with bells, balls, glitter and stars. They put gifts under the tree on Christmas Day. People visit the church and offer prayers to the Lord to seek His blessings.
In today's time, the festival of Christmas has surpassed the religious boundaries and has become a symbol of the holistic culture. The winters in December carry a festive feeling. This is the special season set aside to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. Though this was its original purpose, the celebration of Christmas has grown to become a symbolic time for living in peace and love.
Christmas reminds us of the importance of giving and sharing with family and friends. It shows the importance of joy and happiness. It is also an opportunity to correct actions we are not proud of in our lives. It is generally a time to think about nature and the reason for our existence.
Christmas is also a time when we should think about the well-being and happiness of those people who are less fortunate than us. It is the time when charity works are organized all across the globe and the revenues generated from them are used for the betterment of the poor and needy. People use this time to reconnect with their family and friends over a delicious dinner. They plan games and give them gifts. This fosters the familial ties between people and makes them happier and joyful.
Christmas is essentially a reminder of why we should seek the deepest parts of our humanity. That is, through celebration, we are reminded that we should cheer, give to the less privileged, spend time with our loved ones, and have a positive outlook about life in general. Let every day be Christmas. Christmas is forever, not for just one day. For loving, sharing and giving are not to put away, like bells and lights and tinsels in some box upon a shelf. The good you do for others is good you do yourself.
That was indeed very illuminating. Keeping our Christmas spirits rolling, we have an animation in the pleasant voices of our own school children, Jayvardhan Sabu and Twisha Buddhi Raja, that will depict the sight of the nativity that will evoke the miracle of the conception of Jesus, his humble birth, his ultimate sacrifice, and the gift of everlasting life.
In the beginning, before God created the universe and everything in it, His salvation plan was for Jesus to come to the earth. God selected very special people to be part of Jesus' family. Mary, Jesus' mother, and Joseph, Mary's husband, were part of this special family. It was a family that could be traced back to the great King David, whom God had promised an eternal kingdom. And then to Abraham, through whom God had promised to bless the entire world.
But before Mary and Joseph got married, God came to her and shared some astonishing news. God had chosen Mary to be Jesus' mother. God told Mary that she would become pregnant by the power of the Holy Spirit. When Joseph found out, he was hurt and confused. Heartbroken Joseph considered breaking his engagement to Mary and quietly ending their relationship. Before Joseph could go through with his plans, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. The angel told Joseph that the child Mary was carrying was from the Holy Spirit, and there was no reason Joseph shouldn't marry her. Joseph was amazed and overjoyed by this incredible news. The angel told Joseph that the baby boy would fulfill God's promise to send his people a savior, and the baby should be named Jesus.
The Romans, who were in control of Israel at the time, ordered that everyone under their rule be counted. This meant that Joseph and a very pregnant Mary had to take a long and difficult journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem. The weary couple arrived to find the city overflowing with people who had all traveled to be counted. This presented a big problem to them because Mary was ready to give birth.
Jesus, Lord, have thy birth.
With the inn full of travelers, Mary and Joseph took shelter in the only place still available, a stable. Next to horses and sheep, the Savior of the world was born. Angels sang and nearby shepherds came to worship the newborn king. On the night Jesus was born, a star shone brightly in the night sky over the stable where Jesus was born. It attracted the attention of a group of wise men called the Magi. The Magi, in wonder of this beautiful sight, followed the star in search of Jesus. When they arrived in Jerusalem, they asked King Herod where they could find the child who was born King of the Jews. Evil King Herod, angry at the idea that someone was trying to take away his power, asked the wise men to continue their search and to let him know where the child could be found so he could worship him. But worship wasn't King Herod's plan.
King Herod was plotting to kill Jesus. The Magi followed the star until they reached the town of Bethlehem. Their long and difficult journey came to an end when the star stopped over the place where they found Mary and Joseph caring for the baby Jesus. The wise men bowed down and worshipped Jesus. Despite the humble surroundings, the wise men knew that they were in the presence of holiness. They didn't need to find the baby in a palace to know that it was right to give Jesus gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, which were the types of gifts given to kings. In a dream, God warned the Magi and Mary and Joseph of King Herod's plan to kill Jesus. To help keep Jesus safe, the wise men began their long trip home in a different direction than they came, so they wouldn't run into King Herod. Mary and Joseph scooped up Jesus and escaped to Egypt. They stayed in Egypt until an angel of the Lord appeared in one of Joseph's dreams to tell him that King Herod had died, and it was finally safe for them to return home to Israel. Some years later in Israel, Jesus began his ministry, performing miracles, healing people, and ultimately sacrificing himself to save us from our sins.
I am honored to invite Ashwin sir, who will share his thoughts and blessings and enlighten us.
Good morning to everyone. What is the first thing that pops up in your mind when you hear the word Christmas? Maybe the Christmas tree, the cake, the awesome food prepared during this season, the gifts, and maybe, you know, our dear old Santa Claus. Well, to understand the true meaning and reason for celebrating Christmas, we need to grasp the entire storyline of the Bible. So let me just summarize it for you through this one verse, that is John 3:16, that says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." A very small verse, a verse containing just 26 words filled with hope, beginning with God and ending with life, and urging us to do the same. It's so short and brief that you can probably memorize it or write it down on a piece of paper, yet it is solid enough to withstand 2,000 years of tremendous scrutiny, doubts, and questions. If you know nothing about the Bible, well, start here. And if you know everything about the Bible, return here, for we all need a reminder. Surprisingly, the heart of the human problem is the heart of the human, and God's treatment is prescribed in John 3:16. He loves, he gave, we believe, and we live. I want you to read it again, and do so slowly this time. "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." For God so loved the world. When we think about God or picture him, we get this notion of a God who is always sort of angry, or who always punishes, and who always keeps recycling the world, or who would forsake the world or forsakes the world. But a God who loves the world, especially this world, a world full of heartbreakers, hope snatchers, a world where dictators rise and inflict pain and suffering. And yet God loves. He loves this world so much that he gave his what? His declarations, his rules, his edicts? No. The heart-stilling, mind-bending, deal-making or breaking claim of John 3:16 is that God gave his Son for us, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Well, if you paid attention to the starting lines of the Christmas animation that was just shared with you a few minutes ago, it said, "In the beginning, before God created the universe and everything in it, his salvation plan was for Jesus to come to the earth." Well, the Christian concept of God is of a being who is all powerful, all righteous, all holy, all merciful, and all just. Well, that very God creates us. We sin, we fall, and we move away from him. And there is no way that we can sort of reconcile our relationship and restore our relationship with him. But this God loves the world. He created so much that he decides to step down from his throne and become a part of his creation, so that one day he can sacrifice himself as an atonement for our wrongdoings. That atonement took place on the cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago. And all we need to do is believe. Let me end here with a true story, a very short true story. So there were these Bible translators in New Hebrides Island who were struggling to come up with an appropriate verb for the word believe, as the word believe holds a very important, a very essential belief in the Christian faith. So one translator, John G. Payton, accidentally came up with a solution while hunting with a tribesman. So these two men bagged a large deer and they carried it on a pole. The way home was steep and tiring. When they reached the veranda, both men just dropped the load and plopped on the chair. And they did so with a feeling of being refreshed or being of relaxing. So this native guy, what he did was, as soon as he sat on his chair, he exclaimed in his native tongue, "My God, it is good to stretch out yourself and rest." So this translator, John G. Payton, immediately reached for his pencil and his paper, and he recorded that phrase. Therefore, his final translation of John 3:16 could be worded, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever stretches himself out on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." So as we celebrate the birth of Jesus this Christmas, my prayer for you is that Jesus Christ should be at the center of your heart and the first thing to pop up in your mind when you hear the word Christmas. For we all need rest, and we'll find plenty in the assurance of John 3:16. We should love one another just as God has loved us. I wish you all a very delightful Christmas and a blissful New Year. God bless you all.
Thank you, Ashwin sir. We all are truly enlivened by your words. Christmas now surrounds us. Happiness is everywhere. Sound the trumpet of joy and rebirth as the carols fill the air.
Heaven's glow. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. Sky is riven with angels singing. Gloria, Hosanna in excelsis. Gloria, Hosanna in excelsis. Go tell it on the mountain. Christ is born, while shepherds kept the watching over silent flocks by night. Behold, throughout the heaven there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is. Jesus Christ was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing. A king was born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sin is reconciled. Joyful all ye nation rise, join the triumph of the sky. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero Año Felicidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero Año Felicidad. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of our heart. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of our heart.
The melodious carols have have brightened up our moods. Dear friends, Christmas is truly significant when we celebrate it by giving the light of love to those who need it the most. This year, let's brighten someone's life and let it become the magic for our holidays.
May the setting sun on Christmas Eve quieten your thoughts, the gentle breeze calm your worries, and the silver moonbeams light a path of peace, hope, faith, and grace for you to walk as you meet with the spirit of Christmas. May your Christmas sparkle with moments of love, laughter, and goodwill, and may the year ahead be full of contentment and joy. I, on behalf of the Srijan School, wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a very happy and prosperous New Year.